balance, but the practice itself is balancing yin and yang. Having that feeling right now in your own spirit, whatever's possible at a certain level of presence changes when you shift to a finer dimension, where you're a little more squared away, where you're tuning into more than you were a moment before. There was a guy who trained in Japan around the time Bob did. His name was Henry Kono. At one point, so the story goes, he asked O-sensei, how come we can't do what you can do? How come our Aikido doesn't look like your Aikido? And O-sensei said, because you don't understand yin and yang. Yin and yang, masculine and feminine. The field that you experience as reality is two forces that are a unified field, but it is somehow that mystical interpenetration of those forces that creates reality that you know. But the practice itself is balancing yin and yang. Having that feeling right now in your own spirit. That's the process. In the same way, even when they're a bit tense or resistant or something, the natural reciprocating echo for you is to get tense and resistant and those positions to fight with each other. But the Aikido process should be, okay, that's either too frontal or too back, and you square away and just go to another level. You just start to go to the next dimension of presence for you at that moment. And that's all you are, is just you being you. You feel your front, feel your back. There's a process going on here from level one to level two, level two to level three. And if we went level three to level four, let's just see who shows up for a while. Level four to level five. But the practice itself is balancing yin and yang. Having that feeling right now in your own spirit.